Hello, if you have watched previously my channel, you will see some other statue mosaic cement work that I have done in this summer. And also you will notice that each of them had a theme that I try to follow and represent the subject in that statue. This one, it's like has no subject, are just a bunch of wire poles, chicken wire, and many leftover other metal pieces that I got them when I've cleaned up my garage. So those pieces, metal pieces, I try to put them together and create kind of a modern look art. And I'm going to just try to give you an idea how you can do it. So as I said, I cleaned up my garage and I got a bunch of wires that I don't need them anymore, and the poles from some old rods that, of course, I'm not using them as well. And I got those circles there for towels in a bathroom that I don't need them. And many other pieces, as you can see here, most of them you'll recognize them. Those are from some lamps from the shades that I don't need them anymore. And from faucets, end of them, and other pieces that I have used when I have changed my decor in my bathroom. And here I put together all of them in a sort of the base that has already some cement poured at the bottom, and I try to connect all of them with chicken wire and some wire from the handguns, like wire ones, are very reliable and very good ones for this type of project. And I try to tie them together and create a strong composition. This large piece, rectangular one with a circle hole inside, it's from the hood that I replaced it. And because it's a very nice, interesting piece of metal, I didn't want to throw it away. So I was thinking to give another chance and see what comes out actually from this idea. So at this point, it's hard for you to realize what I'm going to do with this project. But to me, the meaning of this video is to show you how you can start your own project using just unwanted pieces of metal that you don't know what you can do with them. I'm giving you an idea how you can put them together and try to realize like a modern kind of structure for cement mosaic statue art. This is going to be fixed in my garden. Of course, it's going to stay out for the winter, and I will show you how you can preserve this type of work for a very harsh winter that we have actually here in Canada. So this is the basic start for the project, and here I have some enamel pieces of copper that I'm trying to reuse. Them are very nice and very reliable for this type of weather. So as you can see here, I have the fish, I have some birds, I have some plants as well, and a bison. And all of them I will try to just place them on top of this project after I'm going to create a very strong structure using the cement. Here in this pail, I have the cement, and it's a composition that I got from the store in a bags. It's like two part sand and one part cement. You just need to mix it with water to get like almost runny consistency, and that is because you need to just put this type of cement here and needs to get through the holes of this wire. So that's why you need this kind of consistency that gets well through the entire base. So you have to have a very strong structure to make sure that all of the pieces will stay together, because using the cement on top of those wires, entire piece becomes very heavy. So it needs a very, very strong structure. So this is the start of my project. I'm hoping that I will finish it before the weather changes in my area, so I will be able to show you the end look of this project. Of course, I will come with few other videos showing the steps that I followed, so you'll be more than welcome to just follow my idea for this project. A look of the project at the moment. It's still of course in a work in progress. Now you can see the pieces that I spoke about that I'm going to use them for this project, the enamel on copper, and I have here a few other ones like those ones that are on copper. And as I said, I'm going to give them another life in this project. So I have used here a theme with the birds at the bottom, and up here it's a theme with the fish and the sea creatures. And for the rest of them, I'm using pieces of glass that you can see over here and over here as well. I was using bottles. I have here a bottle of beer that I like the color. I broke it, and I'm using the pieces to attach them on the project. And here it's another color for another kind of bottle that I had. And I'm using different types of ceramic, different colors. And I will continue with the pieces of enamel to attach them here and there where I need them. And to attach them, I'm using this type of mixture of pincet that is this thickness. So it's pretty thick. It's because when I'm using a blob of it, I need to, for the piece to stay firmly in its place. So I'm just using on the piece a little bit and just attach it here wherever I think that the piece goes better on the project. So I'll just leave it there to stay, and after that I will come and clean it. Now for the background here, for the fish side, as I said, I'm using the blue color for the background from the glass. And here I have any other colors that I'm working with, so you will see at the end what I was thinking about this project. Again, it's kind of ugly at this moment, it's in work in progress, but I'm sure that at the end you'll understand exactly what I'm looking for. So I'll be back with more updates. So this is the way that the project looks at this moment. Of course, it's in work in progress. I have used the enamel pieces, ceramic tiles, and broken glasses, or bottles of course, and I have used the tin set to just attach the pieces to the project. Now I'm going to use now the grout, and I have here grout purchased from Home Depot. You have to follow the manufacturer's instructions to mix this powder, and the consistency must be like thick yogurt or peanut butter. I'm going to change the color for this grout later and I will show you how you can do it. But at this moment I'm interested just to apply the grout. And I'm using a plastic lid here and I'll just get a blob of it and just start to smear it between the pieces here. So I'll just cover everything with the grout, and when a haze forms on top of it, and that means about 20 minutes to 30 minutes depending of the humidity in your area, I will know that I can come and just clean the grout with a wet sponge, and after that I can give the shininess to the pieces of the ceramic using a dry cloth. So pretty much this is the process now that I need to finish it for the entire piece. And when the grout dries for about 24 hour period, I will just change the color for the grout and I will show you how you can do it. So this is the look of the project after I finished to use the grout on it. As you can see, it's covered everywhere. I've started to change the color for the grout and I will show you how you can do it. I'm using basic acrylic paint, which is very inexpensive. I chose this color because I like it in a contrast with the blue that I have here, and I will show you how you can change the color for the grout from white to desired color. So I'm using straight from the paint here. I'm not using any water, just the paint itself, and I will just touch the white part of the grout. And I will continue to do so everywhere I wish to change the color. And I'm using this procedure because I found out that gives me the strength for the color exactly the way that I like it. Imagine that to turn this white color in this color is going to take a lot of paint. So I'm just doing in this way very fast and very easy, very inexpensive. After I will let the paint to dry for probably 3-5 minutes depending of the humidity in your area, I will come over and clean the mosaic and the glass with a damp cloth. So that is going to stay here on the white grout and dry exactly the way that I like it. To make sure that it doesn't come off from the rain or from the humidity, I'm going to use a sealer at the end. I will show you. And that brings me the strength for the color to remain exactly in the same bright color that I'm using now. So I will continue to use in this way everywhere where I wish to change the color on the project. And that is going to enhance greatly the end look, the finished look of the project. So as I said, I can just use a little like a cloth, damp cloth, and just come over for the only for the mosaic piece and clean it. So the color remains on the grout, but the glass or the mosaic will be cleaned. So that's why you can use this procedure to change the color for the grout. And again, using this procedure is going to enhance greatly the end look of the piece, the finished look of the piece. And I noticed that for my garden works absolutely great. So I'm very happy with this procedure. I will finish to paint the entire piece in the way that I like it, and I will show you the final result for the ensemble. So here is the final look of my project. The theme was a modern approach of a statue with available materials that I had, and I will call this piece the Stylized Clown, and brings together the creatures from the earth and from the sea. So started the project from the idea that I need to use the pieces of enamel that I have them available, representing the birds, the fish, and some other pieces, like small other pieces that I wanted to give them another try. So here you have the base that represents the earth nature, and in a blue, of course, it's the sea part of the project. So from unwanted pieces of metal, wires, chicken wire, cement, pieces of broken bottles and glass, and pieces of ceramic, I have created this large piece that covers here a part of my garden that exactly needs a little bit like color. It's a very large forever green background, so I wanted to just make it brighter. So I got this idea to create this piece. Of course, it's my way of thinking this statue. You can realize your own by trying to start your own project. It's a little bit time consuming, but it's good because gives you the peace of mind, because you need to focus on what you are doing. So it's going to keep you away from the daily life thoughts. It's a way that you can reuse some pieces that you probably don't want them and you are most likely to throw them away. So in this case, you can reuse them and give it another chance for your garden to look absolutely great. For me, the piece, it's exactly where I wanted to be. I have used the technique to paint the grout, as I showed you, and that, as you can see, brings the colors to the mosaic even brighter, much more powerful colors. So overall, I'm pleased with the way that the project came out. Again, it's my imagination. Use your own. See around whatever pieces you have unwanted in a garden, like pieces of metal, and you can just recreate something very useful for your garden, like a design point of view. So if you need more inspirational ideas about my projects, you can check anytime on my channel. I have many others idea regarding the cement blocks, how you can make your own big pots from cement, mosaic art, gardening, 3D wall art, many other more ideas that you can just pick one and you can just develop in your own way to finish it. Now, for this piece to be for a long time in my garden, I need to seal it, and for this I'm using a sealer like this kind here, and you have to leave the entire piece after you'll finish it with the grout and coloring the grout 24-48 hours to dry out, and after that you can give a very good coat of the sealer, leave it to dry of course, and that is going to preserve the piece for many years in your garden. So it's against moisture. So without using the sealer, you won't have a long life for your project. So it's kind of must to use it at the end of the project. Again, I hope that was an inspirational idea for you. I'm hoping that you enjoy with my project. Thank you so much for watching this one. I wish you a very good day. Goodbye.